Well, hello Internet, and welcome to part 12 of my algebra video tutorial series. By the end of this tutorial, you're going to be able to tell people that you can find the reduced row echelon form of a matrix to solve a system of equations. So you're going to be extra smart after this video, and I have a lot to do, so let's get into it. Okay, so we're going to start off with the basics and ramp this up to more complexity. This is probably going to be a two tutorial because there's a lot to process here. Okay, the first thing you have to learn about is what we call a augmented matrix. And what it is it's just combining two matrices. And what we're going to do here is we're going to use equations and we're going to use a new operation to solve system of equations that are much more complicated. And you'll know you're dealing with an augmented matrix if you see this line right here, this dashed line. So I'm going to show you a real world example here. So let's say you have two equations. You have x minus y is equal to 7, and you have 5x plus 3y, which is going to be equal to negative 37. Now, what you can do is you can create what is called a coefficient matrix. And we're going to go like this, and we're going to create one. And what we're going to simply do is take these values that lie in front, and we're going to put them in our matrix. So we have 1 and negative 1, and we have 5, and we have 3. And I think you can see where those come from. All right, so this is a coefficient matrix, and it contains x coefficients on top, and it contains the y coefficients on the bottom. And whenever we solve this, what it's going to do for us is allow us to find x and y on the x on the top and y on the bottom. Now, what we're going to do is create a matrix of constants, and let's give this a name. Let's just call this A, and then let's go B is equal to, and then inside of here, we're going to put our 7 and our negative 37 like this. And then if we create an augmented matrix, what it's going to look like is A dot 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 like this, and B, and we could put our little brackets around here if we'd like, and this is going to end up looking like 1, negative 1, and 5, and 3, and then we'll have our dashes down the middle, and then we'll have 7 and negative 37. So that is how we go and we convert our equations into an augmented matrix. Now what I'm going to do is go through the process of different ways we can manipulate a matrix. Okay, so one thing we're going to have to be able to do here is multiply an identity matrix by another matrix. Now, an identity matrix would just be where we have a 1 on the diagonal and 0 everywhere else. And if we multiply that times another matrix, we'll get 1 and negative 1 and 5 and 3. And this is going to work out. Let's just put this in here like this. So this is going to be 1, 1, this, plus, and I'm just covering some things that we have covered here in the past just to reorient you with them. So how we would multiply two matrices. So look at this, and this is going to be plus negative 1 times 1, and then we're going to have 5 and 1 plus 3 and 0. And then we'll have 5 and 0 plus 3 and 1. And you can see those values. And if you don't remember how to multiply matrices, just refer to previous videos where I cover that. And whenever we go and perform these multiplications and these additions, we're going to get 1 and negative 1 and 5 and 3 as our final answer for how I'm multiplying matrices. Now, I'm mainly going to cover how to swap rows just so you can get more understanding in regards to how symbols are going to work. So let's say we have a matrix here, which is 1 and negative 1 and 7 and 5 and 3, negative 37, negative 6, 2, and negative 6, okay? So this is a matrix. Now, the important part here is to understand these symbols. So we're going to have row 2. That's what that stands for. And whenever you want to swap two rows, you're going to use these symbols right here, and you're going to convert or swap row 2 for row 3. So this stays the same at the top, of course, like that. And then you're just going to have negative 6 and 2 and negative 6 and 5, 3 and negative 37. All right, so that's just the symbol for swapping rows. Also, we're going to have an understanding of what it means to multiply a row by 2. What this symbol is going to look like is 2R1 for multiplying 2 times R1 and then putting the result of that back into R1. All right, so in this situation, we go like this. We could say something like 2 times 1. 2 times negative 1 and 2 times 7. And it doesn't really matter. These are just values that are inside of our matrix. So I'll just keep you from having to watch that. And of course, this is going to end up turning into 2, negative 2, and 14. Like that with our additional values that we have here. The important part is just to understand this symbol right here and what exactly it means. Also, you're going to have to understand the symbols for replacing a row by adding it to another row. So that's going to look like R2. So row 2 plus row 1 is equal to R2. Or you're going to see this instead, more than likely, often drawn like this. So we're going to add what we have in row 2 to row 1 and then put it back into row 2. So, for example, if we have our matrix here, and this is going to be 1 plus 5 and negative 1 plus 3 and 7 minus 37. This will remain negative 6 and 2 and negative 6. And this comes directly from the matrix that we've been working with previously. And then, of course, we can just go and place these values inside of here and then make these additions to get our final answer. Again, just getting you acclimated to being able to see a symbol and know exactly what it looks like. Another thing we're going to be doing a lot of is subtracting a multiple of one row from another. So that's going to look like if we have R2 minus multiple of 3 times everything in row 1. And we're going to be putting that into R2. All right, that's the symbol we are looking for. And once again, we're just going to be going 1, negative 1, and 7. And then we will be having 5 minus 3 times 1 and 3 minus 3 times negative 1 and negative 37 minus 3 times 7. And you can go and work out these equations on your own here. And then this is going to be 1 and negative 1 and 7 and negative 6 and 2 and negative 6. Okay, so there's that matrix. And then, of course, if we perform these calculations, we're going to end up with 1, negative 1 and 7, 2 and 6, negative 58 and negative 6. 2 and negative 6 for our final answer. All right, so hopefully this all is simple and you remember it from the previous videos. And now what we're going to do is we're going to focus on converting a matrix into row echelon form. So what we have here is just the conversion from our equation into our augmented matrix. Okay, you've seen that already. And then what we're going to do is we're going to convert our augmented matrix into row echelon form. What row echelon form simply means is on the diagonal. So here and here. And this is before the dashed line. On the diagonal, we have ones. And down here, underneath all of our leading column ones, we have nothing but zeros. Okay? So if you have a diagonal of ones, and under each of those ones, you have a zero, you have a matrix that is in row echelon form. Now, reduced row echelon form, I think you can see the difference here, is you're going to, once again, have ones on the diagonals. You are also going to have zeros after all of the leading ones, but you are also going to have a zero here in this position. And whenever you get your matrix into reduced row echelon form, you're going to find here with your system equation that this is going to be the value of x and this is going to be the value of y. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to walk you through, like I said, in this video and then again in the next video to show you a bunch of examples of how to solve these so you'll understand. But the basic premise of converting to row echelon form and then to reduced row echelon form, very first thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to convert this A11 part of your matrix in the upper left-hand corner into A1. How will you do that? Well, you are going to multiply the first row by the reciprocal of the number at A11 to make it a value of 1. So, if you have a 6 in the position, like let's say that you have A11 like this, and you want to convert it into a 1, well, you're going to multiply it times 1 over 6. And then, boom, that is going to give you a value of 1. So that is how we are going to convert everything into values of 1s. And later on, when we want to convert A22, whenever the matrix is in the proper format, we are once again going to do pretty much the same thing. Whatever this part of our matrix is, we are going to multiply it times the reciprocal of whatever A22 is. And that's how we'll convert things into 1s. However, we're also going to want to come in here and convert things into zeros. That's what's going on here. So what you do to convert to a zero is you multiply the opposite. So in this situation, we are going to want to come in here and we're going to want to convert this into a zero after we have already converted A11 into a 1. So how do we do that? Well, we multiply the opposite of what A21 is. So if A21 was -5, we are going to multiply times 5. We're going to multiply 5 by the first row and then add it to the second row. So now A11 is equal to 1. And what we're going to do is we're going to take the opposite of -5, which is 5. We're going to multiply it times the first row. So you're going to get 1 times 5. And then you are going to add it to A21. And what does that do? If you add the opposite of one value, -5 plus 5, you're going to get a value of 0. And that's what we do over and over again to solve all of these different equations and put a matrix into first row echelon form and then later reduced row echelon form. So what we have here now is we have for A11 in the upper left-hand corner, we have a value of 1. And for A21, we have a value of 0. So we could come in here and just put 1 and 0 here just to signify that. What we're going to then want to be able to do is we're going to want to put A22 into, make it equal to 1. And how are we going to do that? We're going to, once again, we're going to divide the second row by A22 to make A22 equal to 1. So for example, if it was equal, let's say this is equal to 5, just to use the same value, and we divide it by 5, of course, what are we going to get? We're going to get a value of 1. And now A22 has a value of 1. And then we continue with this process of converting this into a 0 and converting this into a 0 and then converting this into a 1. Whenever we do that, we are officially in row echelon form. And then what we need to do is convert this into a 0. And actually, we would not convert this into that. Just imagine the dividing line here like that. This is where we get our answer. But once we go and we work through this, you'll then be able to get into reduced row echelon form. And how you get that is by multiplying whatever value is at the position of 1, 2, which is a 0, by row 2 and adding it to row 1. All right, so If that was at all confusing, I'm going to work through a bunch of examples here, and I think it will all make sense. Okay, so let's say we have two equations. We're going to have 2x plus 2y, and that's going to be equal to 10. And we're going to have another equation. And remember, the goal here is to find the values of x and y. We're going to have 3x plus 2y. And that is going to be equal to 12. So of course, we're going to convert this into an augmented matrix. So let's just go in here and do that. And I'm gonna have 2, 2, and 10. And I'm gonna have 3, 2, and 12. And we can go and put our dashes inside of there. All right, so the very first thing we want to do is we want to convert the 2 in the upper left-hand corner into a 1. Well, how can we do that? Well, we can multiply 1 half times 2, and we have to do it for everything. So the next one's going to be 1 half times 2, and then 1 half times 10. All right, so we got all those set. This row right here is not going to change at all, so keep those values the same. And whenever we do that, we will get a value here of 1, 1, and 5, and 3, 2, and 12. All right, so we did our first step. Our next goal is that we want to make A21 be equal to 0. So this 3 down here, we want to turn it into a 0. Well, what we're going to do is multiply the first row by the opposite of A21 and add together those rows and assign them to R2. All right, so we're going to say equal to, and this is going to be, what's the opposite of 3? Negative 3. And we're going to multiply that times our first row value, which is right there, which is 1. And then we're going to add it to the value in the second row. So this is going to be 3. And once again, the opposite of 3 times 1, that value right there, plus 2, which comes from right there, and there that is. And then for the final part, we go and do the same thing again. So we're going to have 5 plus 12, and I think you see where those are coming from. And of course, these will not change value. They're going to stay exactly the same. And if I go and perform those calculations, I get a new form for my matrix, which is 1, 1, 5, and 0, and minus 1, and minus 3. So we have two of our values in good position. All right, so now what do we want to do? Well, we want to convert the matrix to row echelon form, and how we're going to do that is by multiplying the second row by the reciprocal of A22. So how do we do that? Well, we will come in here, and we will simply go 0 divided by negative 1, and negative 1 divided by negative 1, and negative 3 divided by negative 1. Of course, these do not change because we didn't do anything with them. And this is going to now have the form of 1, 1, 5, and 0, 1, 3, with our dashes, and there we go. All right, we are now officially in row echelon form, but we can't solve our system of equation until we get into reduced row echelon form. So how are we going to do that? Well, we're going to multiply the second row by the opposite value of A12 and add the rows together and put the result in our first row. So what that becomes is, maybe I should draw arrows here, maybe that makes more sense. Well, I'm going to say negative 1 times 0. Remember, I am once again multiplying the second row by the opposite value of A12, and I'm adding the rows together to put the result in the first row. So this is going to be plus 1. And then we're going to have negative 1, 1 plus 1, and negative 1 times 3 plus 5. And nothing changes on the bottom, so we can just leave those be exactly the same. And then if we perform all of those operations, what we end up with is a reduced row echelon form, which is going to be 1, 0. This value is now 2. And then we have 0 and 1. This value is now 3. We have our dashes. We have our matrix solved. And now we know that the value of x, which comes from here, is going to be equal to 2. And the value for y is going to be equal to 3. And using these exact same techniques, we are going to be able to solve 3, 4, 5, as many equations as you want. And just with some practice, it will become easier and easier and easier and easier. But what I want to do now is I want to show you another way to solve these, because I'm a big believer in the more that you solve, the better you get. All right, so let's say we have two equations again. So we're going to have x plus y is equal to 8, and we are going to have, so we'll say and just to separate that, we're going to have 11x minus y is equal to 16, and this isn't going to be quite as clean as before. We're going to convert this into our augmented matrix. This is going to be 11 and 1, and we are going to have this be 16 and 1 and 1 and 8. Okay, so there is our new augmented matrix. And how are we going to convert this? Well, we could simply come in here and actually put this equation on the top, and then guess what? We would have our 1. But I'm not going to do it that way. I'm going to do it the hard way, just so you get more practice. Okay, so I'm going to use symbols this time to explain what I'm doing. So I am, because that's the reason why I talked about symbols. So I'm going to say what we're doing here is we're going to get R1, and we're going to be multiplying that times the reciprocal of A11. And we're going to put our result of that into row 1. So let's do it. So we're going to have 11 over 11. We're going to have negative 1 over 11. And we're going to have 16 over 11. This row is not going to change. 1, 1, and 8. And if we go and we solve for this, what we're going to get is we're going to get a value for 1. We're going to get a value of negative 1 over 11. And we're going to get 16 over 11. And then we're going to have a 1, a 1, and an 8 again down here. What are we going to do after that? Well, now what we're going to do is I'm going to show you another symbol. So we're going to have R1, row 1, and that is going to be multiplied times the opposite of A21, and then we're going to add row 2 to it, and then after we do all that, we're going to store our result in row 2. So if we do this, this is going to end up working out to 1, let's put parentheses around this, times negative 1 plus 1. And then we're going to have for the next one, negative 1 over 11 times negative 1 and plus 1, like that. And then we're going to have for the last part, let's go like this, 16 over 11 times negative 1 plus 8. And then, of course, the values on the top are not going to change. So we're going to have a 1 here. We're going to have a negative 1 over 11 here. And we are going to have a 16 over 11 here. Working with fractions on purpose just to make it a little bit more complicated. And then if we come through here and we perform these multiplications and additions, we're going to end up getting a value of 0 in our lower left-hand corner. We're going to get 1 over 11 plus 11 over 11. And we will get negative 16 over 11 plus 88 over 11. And, of course, nothing changes on the top, so we'll just have a 1 here, and we will have a negative 1 over 11 here, and we will have a 16 over 11 down here. And if we perform these calculations, this is going to go down here to the next line. What that works out to being is a matrix with a value. You know what? Why don't I put it up here? Instead of doing that, this, what I'm going to do instead is say that this answer is going to go up here because I'm running out of screen real estate. We'll say 1 and negative 1 over 11 and 16 over, this is 11, and this is 0, this is 12 over 11, and this is going to be 72 over 11. All right, so now what do I need to do? Well, I am going to want to convert the, if you have our matrices here, so we'll have A11 and A12 and A21 and A22. What I want to do next is I want to convert this into a 1, and how I will do that is, once again, with symbols here, I'm going to go and get row 2. I'm going to divide it by whatever the value of A22 is, and then I'm going to store that answer into row 2. So let's do it. So I'm going to have 1, let's see here, I'm going to write this. I'm going to have it be 0, and then I'm going to have 12 over 11 times 11 over 12. Okay, so that's what we're doing there. And then for the next one, I'm going to have 72 over 11 times 11 over 12. And then on the top, I'm going to have 1. And this is going to be negative 1 over 11. And then we're going to have 16 over 11. And if we work all of that out, we're going to get a matrix that's going to have a value of 1 here, a value of 0 here, negative 1 over 11 there. We're going to have a 1 here, and we're going to have 16 over 11 here, and a 6 down here. All right, look at us go. We're almost done. So we have it in row echelon form. Now we need to convert it into reduced row echelon form. Again, we're going to use symbols to explain what we're doing. So let me just move this over here, and yes, it fits. So we're going to be taking row 2 times the opposite of whatever the value of A12 is. What I'm doing now is I'm converting this guy right here into a 0. So take that there, put this here, and then to that we will add the result to R1, and we will store it in R1. So what do we need to do? Well, we're going to take 1 over 11 times 0 plus 1. It's going to give us a value of 1. Then we're going to have 1 over 11 times 1 plus negative 1 over 11. What's that going to do? Give us a value of 0. And then we have to do the same thing for all of them. So 1 over 11 times 6. And that's going to be 6 plus 16 over 11, and that's across our top row. And if we go and we add all of these values together, that is going to give us a value of 1, 0, and then we're going to have 6 over 11 plus 16 over 11, which is going to be equal to 22 over 11 or 2. And then we're going to have 0 and 1. And 6 like this. We are now in reduced row echelon form, and that means that this is the value for x, this is the value for y, or you just say x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 6. And there you go. So that's how to solve a system of equations by converting a matrix into reduced row echelon form. And in the next part of the tutorial, I'm going to give you another example that's more complicated. And then I'm going to show you how to solve 3 equations at the same time. So like always, please leave your questions and comments down below. Otherwise, till next time.